Gary Webb, San Jose Mercury News.
You believe in conspiracy theories, Gary?
No, I don't believe in conspiracy theories.
Conspiracies, yes. If I believe it, there's nothing theory about it.
Was the government aware that you were smuggling tons of cocaine into the United States?
Yes, the government knew.
This leads to very sensitive national security matters.
National security and crack cocaine, the same sentence. Does that not sound strange to you?
I'm going to tell you the whole truth. I'm going to introduce you to people you should talk to.
And then you will be faced with the most important decision of your life.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Deciding whether to share it or not.
I gotta admit, I'm a little surprised to see you here today.
What's that?
You're a pretty busy man in between, you tweeted or Facebook, you're done with Avengers, now moved on to Mission Impossible.
Yes.
Right, and somehow you managed to find time to come here today.
You gotta do it.
Yeah,
gotta
absolutely.
Do it. Very important.
Well, and I think you have a little bit more of a personal connection to this, right? I mean, you're also producing, do I get the sense this is a passion project of yours, something you've wanted to do for a while?
I suppose, yeah, I guess, I guess it's a passion project. It's not why my passion. Yeah, I'm passionate about everything I do, though.
Sure.
You know
sure,
what I mean?
Sure.
So,
but I feel like usually when the name pops up also as producer, there's some kind of a little more investment on your part.
Well, yeah, it's not so much an investment as it is, it's a lot of headwind to make movies like this nowadays. It's very difficult, you know, because I'm not wearing a cape, and I'm not a superhero. I'm an anti-hero, really, right? And he's flawed, and he's imperfect, but these are movies that were made in the 70s. Mm-hmm. So that's why I'm passionate about it. So these are movies that were like, All the President's Men, if you will, and things like that, and Pokes View. That's why it's passionate to me. And then ultimately the story that Gary uncovered and the story of him uncovering that story.
Sure.
That's what's, it was interesting to me.
Guys, it's the 80s, it's 10-year-old news. What's the story?
Jerry, just let him finish.
So one of the DEA's most wanted, not only not in jail for eternity, but apparently on the government payroll, admitting in open court that he brought in thousands of kilos of cocaine to the U.S. every day for them.
For who?
The U.S. government, or with them, or at least while they were looking the other way.
Jesus.
This is the biggest story the Merc's ever had.
It still worries me. A lot of blind spots, you know? We don't know Washington. We don't do international.
We do now.
Oh, we do we? How many CIA sources do you have?
None yet.
Get one. What are they saying officially?
They're not even calling me back.
Gary?
You get some sources on the record, we'll see where we're at.
Watch your ass.
Well, and, I mean, it's funny you mentioned hero. I mean, of course, you're a comic superhero. This, I think, some people would consider what he does very heroic. There are, you know, not a lot of people who would really put their life on the line like Gary does here. And I gotta say, you know, watching the movie, there's so many of these, like, what the, you know, moments.
Yeah.
You had those, I'm sure, along the way, researching, discovering more about him and his work?
Yeah, but, you know, I think just because, you know, you're courageous and brave doesn't mean you're heroic. I mean, I feel like that's attaching a label to something with an outcome. I don't know what that is. But, yeah, I think he is brave and courageous. And That was interesting to me, but I also loved his flaws, you know.
Mm-hmm. Was there a scene in this you would peg as one that you were, I don't want to say scared, but that there was more riding on it, getting it right?
Yeah, I think all the stuff that was in the, like with Oliver Platt and all the scenes within the paper, because you know they, you know, because I wanted to show them in a capable light, but then there's over their heads. Mm-hmm. And I don't want to point the finger at them as being the bad guys here, even though that's what broke his back, is the paper retracting his stories and apologizing essentially for it. That's what really ultimately killed him. It wasn't the headwind that it got from his story. But with that, I don't want to like blame them. You know,
sure.
It's not about that, but it's what broke his back. Mm-hmm. So like that part of the story was pretty important to me. And also, it was something that was very foreign to me, being sitting at a paper as a journalist, and sitting around a table. You know what I mean. So it was important for me to spend time at papers and with editors and with other journalists. So yeah, those kind of important for me to get right.
Yeah.
I thought my job was to tell the public the truth, the facts, pretty or not, and let the publishing of those facts make a difference in how people look at things, at themselves, and what they stand for.
We'd never threaten your children, Mr. Webb. What'd you say?
It's over.
I'm not finished with it! I'm not finished!
This is a true story.
Some stories are just too true to tell. Yeah, you beat it for the revolution.